Worship. What is it? Is it music? Singing? Celebration? Is it prayer? Raising our hands or clapping our hands? Webster suggests that worship is to regard with enthusiastic esteem, devotion, honor, and respect. Wait, what was that? Nothing about drums? Organs? Eyes open or closed? Standing or sitting? There was nothing about music at all. So what does that mean? More specifically, what does that mean for us? Is it possible that in our current cultural state, we deviated from what worship was intended to be and turned it into nothing more than a musical genre or a list of rules culminating in personal preference? Is it possible that worship is more about how we live our lives from day to day, moment by moment, than about what kind of music we sing or how we sing it? Don't get me wrong here. Lifting our voices and our hearts to God in song, it's wonderful. But worshiping God, it has to go beyond that. Scripture tells us that if we speak with the languages of angels and men, but have not love, we're just a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. Could it be that how we handle ourselves or interact with others around us is just as important in our worship of God as singing praises to Him? Could worship be about love, about how we speak to or about others? Could it be about serving? Could worship be an act of gratefulness for the things that we don't have or the things that haven't gone our way? Could it be worship for you to stand up out of your seat on a Sunday morning and go walk up to that new person instead of just playing it safe and staying where you were? Please don't be offended, or further offended for that matter, when I tell you that we're all in the same boat here. We're all realizing how very far into every inch of our lives worshiping God has to become. So maybe we didn't get to sing our favorite song this morning, or the drums were too loud, or this, that, or the other. But does it mean we can't worship? Let's hope not. Worship. It's bigger than you think.